Hello everybody and welcome back to Roll with Chico. Today I'm going to be showing you how to do an image transfer onto wood. Here I have two of them that I'm going to show you. I'm going to use the Mod Podge made for exactly this process and the Mod Podge, which we all know is used for many different things. So this is one of many ways to transfer onto wood. You're going to need prints. I went to Copy Max and I printed a couple images, and you're gonna need water, scissors, a brush, sandpaper or foam, sand foam brush. And I have a palette knife because I don't have a squeegee, but if you have a squeegee, that's probably better for you to use. So first you're gonna want to cut your image to the size of your wood panels. So let's start with that. So after you cut your image to your wood size, then you have to prep your wood. So you want to give it a little texture. So you want to use the sandpaper to kind of give it some texture. So then now we get to apply the Mod Podge. So this is the first time I use this. So if you've been thinking about using this, then you can see if it works out for you. Okay, so gotta open this. So you don't wanna add too much to it. I'm gonna do one first. Okay, so you don't wanna add too much to it. And you wanna use your brush. So I'm gonna start with that. And then just brush it all over the area that you are going to transfer your image. So when you are done brushing on the coat of the Mod Podge, then what you're gonna do is make sure that your streaks are even, because you are going to be able to see those on your image. So make sure that the strokes of your brush are even. But if you're looking for that effect of like all over the place, then you can just do it everywhere. So, okay, so then now you're gonna take your image and then also add a coat on this. This one you don't have to add it so thick, or I mean you don't have to add it thick on either, but just a very thin coat on all of it. And also remember, it's gonna dry clear. So once you're done adding the coat to your image and to the wood, then you're going to put it on top. And then make sure you even it out. You can move it a little bit while it's still wet. And with your squeegee, which I don't have one, you make sure you get rid of all the bubbles and make sure like it makes full contact with the wood. And as you're doing this, you're going to have some of the Mod Podge come out. See, I have little bubbles here starting to form. You don't want those. Also, I forgot to mention, if you are doing words, make sure you print them as a mirror image, or else when you take it out, all your words are gonna be backwards. So this palette knife didn't really work. You want to make sure you don't rip your paper. And then some of it is gonna come out. So carefully. Glide it over it. I'm trying to be as gentle as I can. All right. And you're gonna wanna leave this on here until it dries. I've left mine sometimes overnight just to make sure it's super dry. Or sometimes I use the blow dryer. That's also a trick you can use if you're impatient. You can use a blow dryer. So once you're doing that, if you want to apply additional pressure, okay, so I feel like mine is pretty good. All right. You can also layer some books on top and apply additional pressure so you are 100% sure that it's making full contact with the wood, your paper with the wood. Okay, so now we wait. Okay, so these are done. They've been sitting overnight, so they're pretty dry. So now you take your water and you just start brushing it on one area. You're gonna see the image as you're applying it. You can see through. So once it's soaked, you don't wanna do it all at once. You just wanna start at one in one corner and then work yourself to the rest. So just apply the water, and you can either rub it with a sponge or with your fingers. I personally like to use my fingers because I feel like the brush is too rough and it might peel off some of your image. So there we go. And then you want to brush it on, let it soak, and then scrub it away with your fingers. So you're gonna wanna do that to the entire thing. So once you are done peeling it off, it should look similar to this. This one actually came out a little better than this one, not sure why, but they do tend to get a little foggy because of the paper that's still on top. But what you can do is add the clear glaze and it should bring up the color a little more. So I'm gonna apply that. So this is before, but I kind of look like how it looks a little vintage. So this is before, and I'm gonna spray them and we'll compare. So I coated them already and you can see there's a little shine on there. So the image is a little brighter. So I also painted the sides to go along with the beautiful sunset on here. And this one too. And I'm actually very pleased on the how it transferred. So I give this a 2 thumbs up. So again, this is only one way to transfer. There's a million ways to do an image transfer, but I think this is the easiest way and the fastest. Even though I left it overnight, it was already drying as I was applying it. So you do have to work a little fast with this because it is a little thick and it dries. So here it is. You can do portraits, you can do images that you create on your iPad or digitally make them and then you print them out and then you can put them in pieces of wood. This here is also good for fabrics. So if you want to experiment with the fabrics, that would be pretty cool. So please don't forget to subscribe and to hashtag Row with Chico if you do decide to create your own. Thank you for watching and Happy New Year.